Audio Jungle.
Fine. So as I have mentioned, like till now we had seen the energy equation, in means Bernoulli equation, Euler's equation, momentum conservation, all the format like integral and differential form, vector form, all those things we had seen in last session. Okay. So we can prepare the previous lectures. Now onward. We have to discuss the streamline. What is the streamline? So just streamline. Okay. So these lines are imaginary lines. Like in 12th standard and all, you had heard about the magnetic field and all, right? For the North Pole to South Pole, 12th standard physics. So that was like imaginary line. You assume that okay. There are imaginary lines from North Pole to South Pole in the air, and inside the magnet it was South Pole to North Pole. That was you already had done. No? So if you imagine in the same way, so we have a streamline for the fluid. This is also a streamline. Okay? This is also a streamline. I mean, this is also an imaginary line. Okay. Fine. So basically, if you will write the definition in single line, because here the streamline equations equation is very important, because great question they had asked based on the streamline equation. So that will derive. So in one line, I will write the definition so you can understand that. Okay. So streamliner. Streamlines are imaginary curves drawn through a fluid fluid to indicate direction of motion. Direction of motion in various section of the fluid I will explain you what it is of the fluid system This is the definition, but what is the mean of it? So meaning is very simple. Meaning is a tangent at, I will explain you first, you just a tangent at any point. A tangent at any points. On the curve represents the instantaneous instantaneous direction of the velocity velocity of the fluid, velocity of the fluid particles at that point. Okay. What is the mean of it? Simple. Suppose there is a, you can understand by the diagram also. See, this is the point one and this is the point. Means if I draw any imaginary curve, okay, if I draw any imaginary curve and if you draw tangent to that curve, so whatever the tangent you will get on that curve, that tangent will indicate the direction of motion. It will represent the instantaneous direction of the velocity of the fluid particle at that point. Meaning, see, suppose this is the curve. Okay. This is the curve. Okay. So, in short, if you draw the tangent to the curve here, if you draw the tangent to the curve, okay. So, it is nothing but velocity vector at that point. It will give, tangent to the curve will give the direction of the velocity of the fluid particles at that point. Suppose this is the curve, just for example I am showing, otherwise streamline I will show you how it looks like. It is imaginary, this is velocity vector. To understand the whole portion, if you draw the tangent to the curve, so it will indicate the direction of motion at various section. For the curve I am considering the tangent at different location, and whatever the tangent I am drawing, it will give the velocity vector. So that will indicate the direction of motion in various section. Okay. Anywhere. So basically this velocity vector, I mean this is the one curve, like how that streamline looks. If I say the flow direction is from x to y, check what is the mean of it. Suppose this is the direction of the flow. If I say this is the direction of the flow. So direction of the flow means this is what? Velocity vector v. So means if you check this tangent, there was the curve and you had drawn the tangent. So that tangent to that curve will be the velocity vector. So all the velocity vector you are getting in this direction means now this will constitute the flow. It will constitute the flow field, you can say. If you draw the flow field, so this direction, what you have taken, this direction will indicate the direction of the motion of the fluid, means it will be the instantaneous velocity, you can say. Instantaneous direction of the velocity of fluid particles, because if there is the fluid flow, so in fluid flow definitely there are millions of the particles. For all the particles, if you draw the instantaneous direction of the velocity of the fluid particle at for any curve, if you draw the flow fluids are there, suppose, and for the flow fluids there are the millions number of particles. For all the particles you have to show the velocity vector. So if you draw the velocity vector, so it will look like this. For that reason, if you are showing flow field in a pipe flow or something, see, many times you say like, okay, this is the channel and inside this channel there is the flow field. You are showing like this. You say like, okay, this is the flow field. You may say like this. In fluid mechanics, might you have or you can say like, okay, this is what pipe here, okay, this is what, this is the pipe here, and inside the pipe there is the flow of the fluid, yes or no? So this direction you are showing, so hope you understood what is this direction. This direction is basically indicating the velocity vector and how it comes. There was the fluid flow, and for the fluid flow you had drawn the tangent. For that fluid flow, definitely it will follow some curve. Maybe if it is in zigzag motion or it is parallel to x-axis or parallel to y-axis, okay? If you, now for in this case, it is like a parallel to x-axis. So if the flow is what flowing in the x direction, so for the x direction, you may have a curve, okay? A curve like this. Suppose this is the curve now. Now, because it is in x-axis, so definitely it will be one line. And now for this line, if you draw the tangent, for this curve, now this curve becomes, because you are seeing x-axis, so this curve becomes one line, which is in x-axis. If you draw the tangent to this curve, then it will give the velocity vector. And what is the tangent? Tangent will be like this, see? So that's the reason this indicates this fluid flow. So means if fluid is what flowing in x direction, for all the particles, if you draw the tangent, then that tangent will be the velocity vector. Okay. Or you can say it is the instantaneous direction of the velocity of fluid particles. Because if fluid is what flowing, so definitely particles, number of particles will be there. Infinite number of particles, or you can say millions number of particles will be there practically. If you all the particles which is moving in x direction, so definitely if you draw the tangent, so tangent will be, velocity vector will be like this. So always you used to draw the direction of the fluid in this way, but you need to understand what is this. So this is what, this is actually streamlines. You understood my point or not? That's the reason free stream terminology you might have got many times in aerodynamics. You may say like free stream velocity is 50 meter per second. Many times, like in previous classes also, I had drawn the aircraft like this, and this was the aircraft, and I said like aircraft is not moving in this direction, and free stream velocity is like this. So this free stream velocity I said many times like 50 meter per second. So this free stream velocity means what? What? This fluid is what flowing in this direction. If you draw tangent for all the particle, then you will get the instantaneous direction of the velocity of the fluid particles. For at that point, for all the particles, you will get the velocity vector in this direction. So whenever you are showing the direction of the fluid, you need to say, okay, this is what is streamline. Understood or not? So basically, if you say what is the streamline definition, the definition is very simple. I mean, definition, if you say like 2-3 lines definition, you can write or you can learn also. But what is the physical meaning? So this is the actual physical meaning of the streamline. So definitely there will be any curve you can take. Like here I have taken one random curve here. This is the random curve I have taken, which is moving in zigzag motion. And each and every point for the all the particles, okay, this is the one particle. So for this particle I have drawn the velocity vector, I mean tangent I have drawn for the tangent I have drawn to this curve, then it will give the velocity vector. So for this particle, this will be the velocity vector. But at the same time, because it is a zigzag motion, like this is the curve, so next time another particle will have, and tangent if you draw, then for this particle, this will be the velocity vector. Similarly here, another particle will be there, and you have drawn tangent to this curve, so it will give the velocity vector for this particle. But if you assume like your fluid flow is what, not in zigzag motion, it is in one direction, it may be in x direction or it may be y direction. So all the particles will have a same velocity, I mean same velocity vector means it will have a same direction, velocity vector, because I am saying vector. So vector means magnitude and direction. So so direction will be same. I mean, what will be the direction? Where, in which direction the fluid is flowing, in the same direction that velocity vector will be there, and you will draw. Okay, so this like indication is what, it is the direction and magnitude. Direction and magnitude, you know, right? Vector, this is the magnitude, and this arrow will give the direction. So arrowhead is nothing but what? Direction. And this length is nothing but magnitude.
So for the velocity, if you say free stream velocity, so that means you are showing magnitude and direction. So if you are showing that velocity may be in x direction or maybe in y direction, so actually it is streamline. I hope you understood this. So this is the graphical representation of the velocity vector. So it is very clear if you are drawing, this is now velocity vector, okay, this is the fluid flow, this is the flow field, I can say now, flow field. Okay, if this is the flow field, so obviously flow field, it is in x direction, so velocity vector tangent to the curve, if you draw, then velocity vector you may get in x direction. So what will be the perpendicular component? So that definitely perpendicular component will be Vn, normal velocity vector for this fluid flow will be 0. Yes or no? There is, because fluid is what flowing in x direction. Similarly, if fluid is what flowing in y direction, I can draw both. If fluid is what flowing in this direction, so definitely if you draw the tangent, so that tangent will, you may get like this. So that time you may say, okay, flow is what flowing in y direction. Yes or no? In that time you will say like flow is what flowing in y direction. So if I say what will be the velocity vector normal to this, so that time also it will be 0. So what is the conclusion point? Conclusion is very clear. Velocity vector has 0 component normal to the streamline. This should be very clear, okay, because this is the one very good application of the streamline, and that will be used to get the equation of streamline. So what need to write, you need to mention here, because this is the one marks question also sometimes, okay, you have to write velocity vector, okay. So I hope you understood this. So you can say velocity vector has 0 normal component, normal component, 0 component, 0 weight. Because it will not have a proper space. Let me write next. You need to write node point. What is the node? Velocity vector as a 0 component normal to the streamline. Meaning is very clear, okay, because they said the velocity vector will be in x direction only. Okay, so if this is what curve, this is one streamline, this is what one streamline. Okay, this is what one streamline. If I draw the tangent over this streamline, if I draw the tangent over this streamline, so this tangent will give the velocity vector. Okay, means this will be the velocity of these particles, okay, instantaneous, you can say direction of the velocity of fluid particle here, this is the fluid particle. So what will be the normal to this? Normal to this will be 0. There will not be any normal, only you will have a tangential velocity. So you can say this is the Vt. So normal velocity component will be 0, only tangential component you may have. What is the mean of it? Meaning is very clear, means perpendicular to the streamline flow will not be possible. That is very good conclusion, and this is asking exam also. And they are asking. Okay, this is the one characteristics of the streamline. So a streamline at any instant can be defined as an imaginary curve or line in the flow field, so that tangent to the curve at any point represents the direction of instantaneous velocity at that point. Hope you understood this. Alright, this is the very good conclusion. This is the very good conclusion. Now for the same particle, I mean I can draw the that horizontal and vertical component. See, this is the resultant one, because normal is not possible. As I said, only tangential component will have. Okay, tangential velocity you may have. Now this will have a two component. One will be in x direction, another will be in y direction. Yes or no? This x direction component, because this is the velocity vector, and you know velocity vector is what? It is ui vj. Yes or no? Ui vj. Okay. If it is 3D flow, then wk also will come. Here I just want to show you two direction flow. I mean 2D. So in x direction, what component you may have? It is u. In y direction, what component you have? It is small d. All right. You can say here, because this is the particle, so this particle will have a position vector. Okay, what is the position vector here? Position vector, it is nothing but dr, because this is a small element. You know position vector is what? R is equal to what? Mathematics, x, y plus y, z. Okay, so what will be the dr? Dr will be what? Dxi plus dyz. Agree with me? Yes or no? It should be very clear. Now you can say, and for this position vector, hope you understood, this length will be what? Lengthwise, if you say, this is what? Dx, and this will be what? Up to here it is clear or not? Up to here it is clear? This is very important concept here I am explaining, okay? So listen carefully. Fine. And this is what? This is what? This is the streamline. This is the streamline. So now you got what is the streamline, what is the, you know, like is one two property I have explained. There are many properties of the streamline. One property you got, which is very special, and that is normal to the streamline flow will not be possible, or normal component of the velocity vector of the streamline will be zero, or you can say in a technical word, you can say velocity vector has a zero component normal to the streamline. Means Vn will be zero. All right, fine. And for one streamline, you have shown the component also, like x component and y component. Now, if you are suppose interested to write equation of streamline, so what will be the equation of streamline? From here only you can write. You can say equation. This is very important. Many times question they have asked based on equation of streamline. Okay. Equation of streamline. What property you got? You got that. You got that perpendicular component to the this streamline will be zero. Okay. Now if I say, what do you mean by A cross B? If I am writing vector A cross vector B. So where you will get the result of this? That result you may get. You may get A, okay, B sin theta n cap. Okay. What is the n cap indication? In n cap indication is what? Normal to the surface of the AB. Again, I will explain you. Meaning is very clear. Suppose this is what A vector, and this is what B vector. If you write the cross product A cross B, so definitely you will get A B sin theta n cap. That mean is what? It is saying that normal to the surface of A and B, meaning whatever the result after the cross product you may get, that result will lie normal to the surface of A and B. If you are taking cross product of A and B, then where that result will lie? It will lie perpendicular to the A and B. I mean, where is the perpendicular? You can say perpendicular to A and B. So it will be just perpendicular to the this page, perpendicular to your screen will be the result of A cross A vector cross B vector. Hope you understood. So where you will get, as I have shown you, like vector, this is what I, this is what J, and this is what K. So this K is what? This is perpendicular to the plane. Understood? Because three axis, perpendicular, all are 90 degree away, perpendicular to each other. So just like a wall, wall you can see corner, any corner you can see, the corner, two wall and one perpendicular pillar you can say, they connect, two walls will connect, any corner where you are sitting, you can see the corner of the, room. So that corner is what showing that two walls are there, and if you check the pillar, so pillar will be what perpendicular to two walls, yes or no? So in the same way, here you have a K vector, which will be the normal to the surface of A and B. Hope you understood. Now in case of a streamline, what do you have? You have two things. Check. One is position vector and then this velocity. So position vector and this velocity, if you take the cross product, so where you will get the resultant? Position vector and velocity vector, where you will get the resultant? It will be normal to the position vector and velocity vector. You will get the result. What result? Cross product of the position vector and velocity vector. So in case of a streamline, I will write here. You will write the velocity vector, V vector, cross product of position vector. So you know that this result you will get, and that is nothing but normal velocity vector, and this normal velocity vector is nothing but zero. Normal to the streamline, there is no flow, and normal component will be zero. So you can say V into dr, I mean V vector cross dr, which is position vector. If you take the cross product, the resultant will be normal to that, and normal to that is what? It is normal vector of V, and that value is what? Zero, as per streamline property I have explained you. So based on this, you can write the equation of the streamline. So what is the V vector? As I told you, it is ui plus vj, okay? And if you take the cross product, so dr is nothing but dxi dy j, okay? How to solve cross product, you know that, yes or no? If you check, and if you are considering it is 3D, so what is the V vector? Ui Vj Wk. It is like okay. This is U, V and W. You can say this is nothing but Px this is nothing but dz, yes or no? So here for the 3D, if you write dr vector, position vector, dxi dyj dz. If you write the cross product, so cross product you can write U V W. Yes or no? Cross product, if you write, then this is the U V W, and here DF dy and dz, yes or no? Correct. So cross product, if you write, then what you will get? So you take the cross product and you are having a vectors which is nothing but ijk. So you write here i
देख के एंड सॉल्व इट, यस और नो? प्लीज सॉल्व इट,
एंड इफ यू सॉल्व देन यू मे गेट द रिजल्ट.
ओके,
what you may get,
BDZ minus, wait, BDZ minus W DY, then next time it is plus minus, so minus J, then middle line you have to cross, then what you may get, U DZ minus W DX plus K last line you have to cut, and what you may get, U DY, U DY minus VDX. You can write 0i, 0j plus WK.
This one you can write just for your. All right. For your convenience, you can write.
You can write, check. In short, here you can write. Zero I, zero J plus zero. Because this VDR is what? It is nothing but 0. This value is what? 0 or not? Cross product. Because you have seen here, see? This is what? 0. Huh? If you solve it, then what you may get? There are three equations. What is that? VZ minus, VDZ minus WDY. You have right, then what we have? We have W DX minus C, this minus you have to multiply here inside. If you multiply inside, then what you may get? W DX plus minus U DY. So you will have and then last W, sorry, U DY minus V DX. This is the third. This is what? Equation of stream. All right. What is the another format? Another format you can say. UDZ or VDZ is equal to WDY, okay, or you can write, for this you can write DZ by U is equal to DZ by W. DZ by W is equal to D by V, you can write. Now, similarly, what you can write? W DX is equal to U DZ, which means dx by u is equal to dz by w you can write. Third, what you can write? Dy by v is equal to dx by u. Okay? Or what you can write? Combine all three, then what final result you may have? Check dy by v is equal to what? Dz by w. So I must write, and dx by u is equal to dz by w. So I must write dx by u is equal to, check dx by u is equal to, this is also dx by u is equal to what? Dy by v. And check dx by u is equal to also dz by w. This is the streamline equation. Okay, this is the streamline equation. For the for the 3D flow. Okay, you need to remember this is the masterpiece, no? Master formula. Gate question they had asked to you. Okay, this is the equation of a streamline. Or for 3D flow. All right, remember it. This is the equation of a streamline, and this equation is also in Cartesian coordinate. In Cartesian coordinate, Cartesian coordinate. All right, I hope you all understood. Fine. So I hope you understood the equation of the streamline in Cartesian coordinate. Now we'll go for the next part, which is the characteristics. So important characteristics I will write. Okay, important characteristics, because many characteristics are there, total 7 to 8 points, but important I will write. Characteristic of streamline. Number one is streamline do not cross to each other. Streamline do not cross to each other. Why? Because each streamline tangent will give the direction. You think about it. Okay. Each streamline, suppose this is the one streamline and this is the another streamline. Okay, this is the another streamline. Two streamline you have. So they cannot cross each other by Because if they are crossing to each other, then what will happen? Because tangent to the streamline will give the velocity vector. This is one velocity vector. Suppose this is the streamline 1, so V1. And this is the another streamline, which is called number 2 streamline. So tangent to this streamline also will give the one velocity vector, so V2. So V2. Huh? So at one point, at point O, they are crossing to each other. If they are crossing at point O, so definitely at point O, two velocity vector you may have, like this is one velocity vector and this is another. So at single point, two velocity vector will not be possible. For that reason, we have to say they cannot cross to each other. Hope you understood. Okay. If the fluid is what flowing at one point, only one direction will follow. At single point, that fluid flow can have two direction, not possible. Okay. Practically, it is not possible. You can think. So that's the reason number one. It is very important. Okay. It is a very important number one characteristics point is it cannot cross to each other. Okay. Otherwise, what will happen? Otherwise, fluid particles will have two velocity at the point of intersection, and physically it is not possible. So I must say physically not possible. Physically not possible. That's the reason they cannot cross to each other. All right. Number two. The streamline can intersect at isolated point of zero velocity. Means if it is a stagnation point, where velocity at a stagnation point, what is the velocity? Zero. So it is kind of isolated point. Okay. At that point they can intersect. Why? Because at the stagnation point velocity will be zero. If velocity is zero, they can intersect, because that time if fluid is not flowing, what was the physically not possible thing? Physically not possible thing was like if they will cross to each other, then the fluid particle, single particle, will have a two direction at one point. But if it is a stagnation point means there is no velocity, there is no flow, velocity becomes zero. I mean, there is no flow doesn't mean there is no flow, fluid is not flowing. But if it is a stagnation point, so at that point velocity will be zero. It isentropically comes to zero, called stagnation point. If isentropically fluid flow come to rest, then that point will be called stagnation point. This is the definition. If I say stagnation point, then it means that fluid at that point is what, at rest. There is no motion. If there is no motion, so it is V1, V2, V3, V4, doesn't matter, because fluid is not flowing, so there can be infinite number of velocity vector. That can be, okay, that can be, because fluid is not flowing. So you can say streamline can intersect at isolated point of zero velocity, okay, or infinite velocity. That time also you can, because infinite is what is someone hypothetical thing. So that time also possible. So need to write this point. I can say, because this is the single marks question, then nowadays they are asking multiple select kind question, MSQ, multiple select question. So there will be chances to like out of four options, there may be chances more than two or three options may be correct. So if, and in that also theoretical question they are asking nowadays. So be aware with this, okay? So I can write if streamline can intersect at isolated points of
zero velocity, which means the stagnation point. So at the stagnation point, they can cross to each other. Okay, or it is having infinite velocity. I will show the diagram. So these two points are very important. Make a mark of it. So I will show you now by the diagram. If you check, it is like okay. This is the surface, okay, and this is the one surface. Okay, it is like this. Now check two diagram I have drawn here. Okay, you draw the tangent point for this. If you draw the tangent, fluid flow will be like this, and fluid will be like this. Okay. So at this point, they are crossing to each other. So that time, this will be the V1 vector, and this is the V2 vector. So here they can cross to each other, streamline can cross to each other, but this point must be a stagnation point. Then only it can cross to each other, otherwise not possible. This is, and again here also we need to draw the this is the tangent. Okay. And here also. If you draw the tangent, so tangent will, so till infinite they are not crossing to each other. So you can say it may cross to each other, but it will be an infinite point because it is going. So because infinite is one hypothetical set thing. Okay, you may say like, okay, it can intersect, but it will be an infinite. You don't know where it is, but at least here it is not crossing. So this is like, here you can say at infinite, okay, because in this case definitely V1 and V2, if you say here you have written infinite velocity and it is going to infinite point and there it can cross to each other, but at least here it cannot. Okay, so this is what, it is the V1 vector and this is what, V2 vector. So this shape is what called cusped shape. What it is called? Cusped shape. Okay. And this is what surface. So here the stagnation point is, it can cross, and this is going to infinite if it is cusped shape. So here also they can cross to each other, but it will be with infinite velocity because it is infinite point. Some infinite, any infinite point will be there at infinity. Okay, there it can cross to each other. At that time velocity will be infinite velocity. That is the whole thing is what hypothetical. Hope you understood this. Okay. Now, third is very important, spacing. Okay. Third is very important. It is related to spacing. Streamline spacing varies inversely as the velocity. You can write this.
streamline facing facing varies inversely as the velocity
if it is convergent of streamline in any particular direction shows accelerated flow in that direction. So whole thing is what streamline spacing, it is inversely proportional to the velocity of flow. What is the mean of it? Check. Now this is the streamline. I mean, this is the flow field, so definitely this will be the streamline also, no doubt about it. If you draw the streamline, the streamline will be like this. Okay, here. But maybe sometimes streamline may be like this. So if this is the streamline, so here area and here area, both places, if you check the area, it is converging, okay, and they are not crossing each other, okay, remember it. But here it is diverging. This is what diverging. Understood? So convergent and divergent, it is just opposite to the, because convergent means what? What is spacing of streamline is what? Less spacing of streamline is less, and in case of the divergent, spacing of the streamline will be more. Okay, so here spacing will be more, spacing will be more. So spacing, if it is spacing is what? Less. Okay, if spacing is less, then what will be the velocity? Velocity will be more here. Yes or no? More velocity. And here less velocity. Understood? In single diagram I will show you. Two streamline we have. Streamline one. Here it is, and here it is conversion. This is called conversion. Conversion of the streamline. Okay, and this is what? Divergent of streamline. Yes or no? So this should be very clear. Okay, single marks question they are making here. Now it is clear. Convergence and divergence. So whenever the streamline is what converging, spacing is less, so velocity will be more. So here you may have more velocity. Yes or no? High velocity. Flow velocity will be high here. Low velocity. Hope you understood this. Alright. Fine. So similarly, there are 7 points. We'll send the PPT, you can read. No? We'll go to the next. It is called stream tube. What is the stream tube? So simply you can understand by the word only, stream tube. So stream is streamline and tube means what? It's a channel, one kind of channel, okay, maybe open or closed channel. So basically, if more number of streamline comprises, okay, more number of streamlines or more number of stream filament, you can say, comprises, and it will make one kind of the channel. It may be open or it may be closed channel, then it will be called as a stream tube. So number of streamline or number of stream filaments comprise a stream tube. A stream tube represents the elementary portion of flowing fluids bounded by a group of streamlines that confine the flow. Okay. If the stream tube's cross-section areas is sufficiently small, the velocity of the midpoint of any cross-section may be taken as average velocity for the section as a whole. The stream tube will be used to derive the equation of continuity for a steady one-dimensional incompressible flow. That's the use of the stream tube. So like what I had said, it will be very clear if I will draw the diagram. So now check. They are like saying, suppose now these are the streamlines, okay. Fine. Now they will comprise and will make one tube. Okay. Similarly, I can draw here. Okay. Now this can be drawn like this is the complete circle. Here it is. Okay, I'll try. Okay, fine. Now, so it will be like this is what is stream tube. Okay, so if there are many number of streamline or stream filament or group of streamline, and it is bounded, okay, and it may look like a cube. So which is the one channel, okay? Then what is the use of this stream tube? It is basically used to derive the equation of continuity, because what is the continuity equation? That mass conservation. So your imagination is what? For mass conservation means there is no, like mass is what conserved, means there is no outflow. Outflow in the sense, if through the channel, if there is the inflow like this, suppose this is the inflow here, this is the inflow, the same amount of will have outflow also. Yes or no? This is the only mass conservation. There should not be any leakage. Okay, there should not be any leakage perpendicular to the channel. In which case it is possible? Only streamlined. Why? Because that property you have seen. What is the property? Property is very clear. Property is normal to the streamline, velocity vector will be zero. Means if you make one tube here with the help of streamline, so you just imagine now this is the one pipe. So there for the pipe, suppose see this is the one pipe, na? Channel. So all the streamlines, group of streamlines make one channel, just like a pipe, and if there will be leakage in pipe, then what? It is perpendicular to the surface, okay? If there is a leakage in a pipe, then it will be like a perpendicular to the surface. But if it is streamlined, then what is the perpendicular velocity? It will be zero. Means that leakage cannot be possible in case of the stream tube. That's the reason for the derivation of stream mass conservation, that is derivation of continuity equation, you have to use this stream tube. Because as per your characteristics of the streamline, perpendicular flow to the surface, because it is now one surface, all the streamline in a group of streamline, it will confine the flow, okay? And if it will confine the flow, then perpendicular to this channel, flow will not be possible. Why? Because it is made by the group of streamlines. And you know the characteristics of the streamline, perpendicular to the streamline, flow will not be possible. Normal component will be zero. Normal component zero means all the flow is what in tangential, means all the flow you may get here only. Perpendicular you may not get. Why? Because it is the characteristics of the streamline. So this is the use of the stream tube. You have to remember this. They can ask for single mark. Okay. So basically, what is the use of the stream tube? The stream tube will be used to derive the equation of continuity for steady one-dimensional incompressible flow. Why in one-dimensional? Because only one dimension that flow can be possible here. Okay. So here you can write. Okay, use. That use of stream tube. What is the use? Derive the continuity equation. Derive the continuity equation. For what? For steady flow, okay, and steady incompressible flow. Incompressible flow, okay, and remember it is only flow. So you can say steady flow or steady only flow. Here I will write only flow. Hope you understood. This is very important. They can ask question. Okay. So basically a stream tube represents the elementary portion of flowing fluid bounded by a group of streamline. Here I have shown you 4-5 streamline only, but there is a multiple number of streamlines. So you can imagine it will be like one surface. If more number of streamlines will be there, it will make one surface. So it will confine the flow. I mean in the direction it will confine the flow, okay, and it will be used to derive the continuity equation for only steady and incompressible flow. All right, always remember. Now, very important grid question they had asked based on this, which is called path line. Path line. Just like the streamline, this path line is also very important. Okay. So basically, path lines means what? By the word only you can understand path. So one fluid flow will be there. Then particle of the fluid will trace one path. Okay. You just imagine. Suppose there is the fluid. These are the fluid particles. These are the fluid particles. Okay. These are the fluid particles. When it will start flowing, so it will trace one path. That fluid particles may go like this, or it can go straight also. The fluid particles may go like this, or it can follow the straight path also. Doesn't matter. Similarly, this is the particle one. Similarly, this is what particle two. Particle 3, particle 4, yes or no? So this particle can follow the path like this, okay. Third particle also can follow the path. It will also follow the one path. Okay. Similarly, four particles, number four, it can follow path like this. Yes or no? So what is the overall idea? Overall idea, path lines can intersect to each other. Why? Because it is not showing any kind of the direction of the fluid flow. Okay. It is simply a path line represents the trace or trajectory of fluid particles over a period of time called path line. So once, because if there is a fluid flow, in fluid flow there will be not infinite, but number of particles will be more, millions number of particles will be there. So each and every particles will follow their own path. Okay. It may be a straight path, it may be even like zigzag motion, because if it is turbulent flow, means what? That particle will move in zigzag direction. Got my point? So the thing is, for the path line, why I have drawn this diagram? So you can, it should be very, because single marks question can ask. They will say like a streamline cannot intersect to each other. Path line cannot intersect to each other. Okay. So streamline cannot intersect to each other, that is correct. But path line cannot intersect to each other, that is not correct. It can intersect multiple times. Multiple times it can intersect with each other, because it is not a velocity vector. Means if it is following one path, if over the path, if you draw the tangent, it will not give any velocity vector. It will not give any direction of the fluid flow. No. That is only streamline. Path line means what is the path particles is what following during the motion of the fluid. That is called path line. Okay. Like when from the, like, see railway station and all, people, they are moving to like each other. I mean, they are moving in zigzag motion. Okay. Or any point where there is the rush. So they are following their own path and they are moving zigzagly, but they are crossing to each other also. It doesn't mean someone is what? Suppose Rakesh is what going this path, so Ramesh cannot go through that path, or Rakesh and Ramesh cannot follow the same path. It is not like that. They can follow. Hope you understood this. So this is called path line. Okay. So all the particles here I have shown you, that is the trace path they have followed. Okay. So a path line represents the trace or trajectory events of a fluid particle. Understood? This is number one, number two, number three, and this is number four particles. Okay. So basically, a path line. A path line represents the trace or trajectory of fluid particle over a period of, here I am writing the pressure for a single particle. Similarly, many particles can be possible at a single time, period of time called as path line. Okay. Fine. Equation of path line, need to write. Equation of path line. Equation of path line. So how to write the equation? Simple. Equation of path line. So now you can say any particle we can take. Suppose this is the particle one. Okay. It is going to follow the path. Okay. So for this particle, I can say if it is, moving in the direction, any direction. So for this particle, we can take the component. In x, y, z, okay. We can take the component x, y, z. You can say if it is moving. If it is moving a distance of dx in a given time t or dt, dx distance in a given time dx distance in given time dt. Because it is moving in x direction, so what will be the equation of path line? You can write u is equal to dx by dt. Similarly, v is equal to, we can write dy by dt. Similarly, w is equal to d is divided by dt. This is what equation of path line. Understood? So, like if you very basic, if you study fluid, then there are two methods to understand the fluid, Euler's method and Lagrangian method. So path line is the outcome of Lagrangian method, and streamline just the outcome of Euler's method. That in that way you can understand. A path line can intersect itself at different times. This path line can intersect itself at different points. okay. This is the path line, right? They can intersect with at different times, they can intersect itself only. Like the best example, the path traced by a single particles of smoke swing from a cigarette is a path line. Okay, that smoke you might have seen somewhere, chimney or anywhere you might be have seen. So any particle of smoke, you can see that smoke particle is what moving here and there, here and there, here and there. So what is the path by that single particle is what traced, called path line. But it doesn't mean through that path another particles cannot pass. It can pass. In fact, the same particle traced the path and it can intersect multiple times, but it will be different time obviously, because one particle can be at one place at one time. Different time it can cross the path. Hope you understood, right? This is the equation of path line. U is equal to dx by dt, v is equal to dy by dt, okay, w is equal to dz by dt. Here I have shown you by only in terms of u, means in x direction. Similarly you can show in y direction, like here in y direction also you can write for this if it is in y axis. Okay, hope you understood. Okay, the path line basically shows the direction of velocity of the same fluid particle at successive instant of time. All right, so these are the different definition. Okay, fine. Now we'll go for the next another line called the streak line. What is this streak line? What is the streak line? It is again very simple. Streak line. The streak line is what? Basically, it is an instantaneous picture. Okay, it is the instantaneous picture of the position of all fluid particle that have passed through a fixed point in a flow field. Through a fixed point in a flow field called the streak line. How to understand this? You take one example of the smoke particles. Okay, you just say this is the okay. You just say now fluid is what flowing, or smoke particles this is the one fixed point. Okay, from this fixed point definitely particles will go here. These are the particles. Got the point or not? Anywhere, I mean, this is what chimney, you can say, no? So this is what fixed point. So through the fixed point that particles will be passing you take the instantaneous picture. If you take the instantaneous picture, okay, of the particles, then you will get the positions of the fluid particle which is passing through a one fixed point. Okay. If you joint all the particles, if joint the particles like this, this will be what? Equivalent. Understood?
Listen one more time.
It is the instantaneous picture of the position of all fluid particles. Here I am showing one diagram. Similarly, you can multiple fluid particles you can draw and you can understand. So it is the instantaneous picture of the position of all fluid particles that have passed through a fixed point in the flow field. Now another diagram like here. See, I can show another diagram here only. Check, it is already there. So this is the suppose one channel, and I can take fixed point here, and multiple particles will be going like this. If you take this instantaneous picture, so all the particles will have their own position. If you draw, connect all the particles which is passing at single point, fixed point, then you will get the line which is called a straight line. So a line formed by a smoke particles ejected into atmosphere from a fixed nozzle constitute a streak line. Constitute a streak line. Understood? So the particles emerges from the origin fixed point, and each particle has its own trajectory. Yes or no? So if you follow each particles their own trajectory, you may get the path line, and what instantaneous picture you may get, the streak line, is obtained by joining the instantaneous position of different particles that have passed through the fixed point. Okay, that I will show another diagram, so it will be more clear to you. Now check this diagram. It is very simple, but the thing is, we need to understand by the diagram. Okay. Now, suppose this is the origin. Okay. Somewhere I have to draw the origin. I can say this is the origin point. Check origin. Okay. So I am just taking the particles and it is following the path. Suppose this is the one particles I am taking from this fixed point, that particles are going away, and one particles I am taking, this is going like this. Another particles also I am taking, this is going like this. Like this. Understood? All the particles we have here, particle 1, this is the path traced by the particles. Okay. If you take the instantaneous picture, then the particle position will be like this. Okay. If you draw these particles, one particles and another particles, by dotted line like this, these are the instantaneous position of the particles. Okay, by dotted line if I draw like this,
here also it should be drawn by the dotted line better, no? So these are the what? Streak line, and these are the path line. This one, and this one. This is the streak line. This is the streak line. So don't get confused. Only one I will draw, so it will be better. So where is the path line and where is the streak line? Understood or not? All right. Path line and streak line. So basically, it is the instantaneous picture of the position of all fluid particles that have passed through a fixed point, in a flow field. Understood? This is the streak line. Is that clear to you? Okay. This is what origin. This is the origin. So that dashed line here, all the dashed line, it is the streak line, and complete line called the path line. Okay. So streak line is obtained by joining the instantaneous position of the different particles. Like here in this diagram, it is clear. Okay, but still, if you want, if this one is clear diagram, here you can say we have a multiple particles. If you draw this particle by dotted line, so this will be what? Streak line. Yes or no? Will be the streak line. In this way, it will be easy to understand. So example, like a smoke particle ejected into atmosphere from a fixed nozzle constitute a streak line. Okay. Fine. Very important note which is asked in GATE. What is the important note? Note is for the GATE. Okay. What GATE question they had asked? For a steady flow, there is no geometrical distinction between streamline path line and straight line. They are coincident if they originate at originate at same point. Okay, so for steady flow, all three, streamline, path line and streak line, are coinciding coinciding to each other. It is coinciding to each other, so we cannot differentiate that path line, streak line streamline, path line and streak line. We cannot differentiate if it is steady flow. Why? Because they are coinciding to each other. If it is originating at the same point, then they will coincide. So because of it, because throughout the study, until unless you will not go for unsteady aerodynamics, you are studying steady aerodynamics only. Okay. If it is unsteady aerodynamics, especially it is one subject in M.Tech, specialization unsteady aerodynamics. But here you are talking about steady aerodynamics throughout your B.Tech level or gate syllabus and all. So for that reason, all three lines, streamline, streak line and path line, are coinciding to each other. So you are talking only streamline. In definition, you will learn here, but further you will not get any path line or streak line. No, you will not get. Every time you will get a streamline. Because you are presumed it is steady flow. And if it is steady flow, so all three coincide. If it is coinciding to each other, so only one you may get. Or you can say, in simple word, you can say it is overlapping to each other. It is overlapping to each other. Yes or no? If it is yes, if it is originating at the same point, all three, the streamline, then here we have a path line and here we have a streak line for steady flow. This is the origin. Hope you understood, no?
All right.